when people come to me and they say, Jeff, you got to have full motion video color on the Kindle. I say, why? You think Hemingway is going to pop more in color? You know, so we're doing a particular thing. And so when somebody says to me, you know, you need to add the full motion video and all these things that the iPad has, I say, well, you know what? You don't understand my audience. I love you, but you don't understand my audience.
And you don't understand how many Kindles I've sold.
Well, that's true. It's also working. That's the other argument I can use to rebut that.
But the bottom line for you is that for reading,
people want
a designated device.
Yeah, they want a purpose-built device that's where no trade-offs have been made, where every single design decision as you're walking down the process has been made to optimize for reading. The number one thing that people are doing on their iPad right now, if you look at the rankings,
is
they're playing a game called Angry Birds, where you throw birds at pigs and the pigs blow up. The number one thing that people are doing on their Kindle right now is reading Stieg Larsson.
But there's an application for a Kindle on an iPad.
Yeah, absolutely. And also on Android, also on the iPhone, also on the Mac, also on the PC, also on your BlackBerry. So our approach is when you buy a Kindle book, we want you, it's buy once, read everywhere. So you buy that Kindle book, and we have a technology called Whisper Sync. So we'll synchronize your place, and you can read a little bit on your BlackBerry, read a little bit on your iPad. Then if you're going to have a two-hour reading session, get the Kindle and get a device that is really optimized for long-form reading.
The argument being made for the Kindle, and you make it as well as anyone else, is that it's easy to read, that your eyes will tire.
Yeah,
because of backlighting from an iPad.
It's like reading, when you read, what's the first thing, when you have to read a long document on a computer, what's the first thing you do? You print it out.
Oh, yeah, sure, yeah.
Because when you're looking into a backlit display, which is the traditional LCD kinds of computer displays, and it's what you have on smartphones and tablet computers and so on, the contrast, the light, that's, it's like reading with somebody shining a flashlight in your eyes. And so the electronic paper display, like what you're holding there now, is a completely revolutionary kind of display. It looks nothing like a computer display, and still most people have never seen an electronic paper display. They think of a computer display, but when you see one of these, you do a double take because it's so different.
When the iPad came along, the price of books made publishers happy on the iPad. Books here $9.95, books on the iPad $13.95, I think. Tell me the impact of all that.
Well, we have 630,000 books that you can read that we sell in the Kindle store. That doesn't even include the 1.8 million public domain, out of copyright, pre-1923 books. But of those 630,000 books, 510,000 of them are $9.99 or less. Same thing, if you look at the New York Times bestseller list, there are about 112 titles on the New York Times bestseller list. In the Kindle store, 81 of those 112 titles are $9.99 or less.
Is there a lag time between the time of publication date and when you can buy them for the Kindle?
No, not anymore. A few publishers experimented with that, and readers really rebelled against
it. Sort of like the release of movies.
Yes, that idea of windowing. And the readers really rebelled against it, and publishers aren't doing that anymore.
So you are counting on the fact that people want to have an extra device for reading. And therefore, you are opting to make it smaller, easier,
and
thinner.
You got it. And at $139, at $139, you know, people are going to have, I think we live in a multi-device world. You're going to have a tablet computer, like an iPad or one of its competitors. You're going to have a smartphone. You're going to have a laptop. You know, the tablet computer isn't going to displace the laptop because there are times when you want to write a long memo or a long email message or an article.
As someone said, the iPad for receiving things, not sending things.
Exactly. And
except for email.
And likewise, if you want to sit down and read a 300-page book.
Or create things.
The Kindle is the perfect device to sit back and read a 300-page book. And by the way, at $139, you know, some people spend more than that for their sunglasses, Charlie. Okay. I mean, it's not an expensive device.
Having said all of that, the guy who's staring at you is Steve Jobs, who has a phenomenal track record with the iPhone and the iPad. Are you worried at all about this? Because
let me give you a little broader context. If I, you know, put not just my Kindle hat on, but my Amazon hat on. If you look at tablet computers, we're very excited about tablet computers, definitely including the iPad, because they have great web browsers and they make it easier for people to shop at Amazon. So, you know, every internet-connected device, that's going to be an incremental tailwind for our business. And we're seeing lots of traction with the Android smartphones, with the iPhone, with the iPad. People are using these devices to shop on Amazon.
But, and are you here to also say that it is not all that certain that iPad will dominate that tablet market, that their competition will be good in the same way that the Droid X is beginning to make some progress Android
absolutely.
Operating system?
There, before the end of this year, there'll be many tablet computers. And, you know, the Apple with the iPad is going to continue to do extremely well. And I hope they do. We don't see from where I sit, all the data that I have, the evidence is very clear that Kindle is a companion to tablet computers, laptops. It's not
What's
an either-or decision. Well, we have this feature called Whisper Sync, where you can read on one device. And one of the strong usage patterns that we see is people will read on their Kindles, and they read on their, you know, smartphones, tablet computers, and so on. So we're seeing that people are moving between these devices, and it's one of the reasons that we are so focused on buy once, read everywhere.